thanks for choosing GoldSeek.com Radio as a trusted business and investing news source.
Just a pleasure to welcome back Peter Grandich from Peter Grandich and Company. He's had some fantastic calls recently that we're really looking forward to sharing with our listeners today. Welcome back, Peter Grandich.
Good to be back with you, Chris.
Thank you. And, you know, we've had a lot of interesting market action lately. You were looking for the precious metals to put in a rally, and we've had quite a rally. Silver, of course, really shone brightly last week. Can you tell, you know, what led you to your call and what you see on a forward basis?
Last July 31st, I made a personal decision to liquidate all non-gold-related equities but one and build a very large gold-related portfolio through physical bullion and other types of vehicles, ETFs, a couple of individual stocks, what have you. And I maintained that and through the latter part of the fall built it up and stated and believed that it would outperform the general equity markets going forward from that point. I don't have any, I don't sell it. I don't have any relations with mining companies for 6 years. There's nothing in this for me other than my personal gains, and it was a decision I didn't suggest to every person to do, but it was really to point out two things. One, that I thought the general equities market was coming towards an end, which I believe it's been forming a major top. We can discuss that in a moment. But more importantly, that a new mega bull market would be born in gold, and it would have three legs. The first I spoke of, and everybody knew that. It had to get through certain resistant levels between 1350 and 1375, and I call that the first leg, and we've had that. The second leg is what we're going through now, building a base above that resistance, and then eventually moving towards 1500. And then once we go through 1500, if I'm correct, then we'll really see a great acceleration, because that should be during the same phase that the stock market has now clearly topped out to a lot of people, and money will flow into the metals seeking an alternative from the general public and, you know, the Johnny-come-latelys. And by then, one should have already been positioned in such things as physical bullion and things related to it. And at the same time, as I noted most recently, just a couple weeks ago, I used a terminology I have only used four or five times in the 35 years I've been around the financial arena, and that is, I felt that the stock market's gotten to the point where there was a reasonable chance of a crash, or at least a very sharp decline, something more than a correction. And I've actually established an initial short position, but I've been waiting for what I had hoped to been was a mini melt up into this inevitable interest rate cut a week or so from now to really establish that short position. I don't know if I'm going to get that opportunity, but I really think this is the bottom of the ninth, with no extra innings coming to the equity market. So all in all, I would say the answer to your question is that I think gold is just in the early stages of a second phase, and silver is now joining it. We could talk about that as well. And I still think there's time for people to participate in it. But once it gets going, particularly once gold gets above 1500, which is still possible this year, and more likely it may take us to the spring of next year. But once that does, then I really think it's going to accelerate, and before our eyes will be challenging to make a new all nominal, new high, time high.
Well, first hat tip for that great call. I mean, you know, we do have the FOMC meeting with the Fed Funds Futures decision, I guess, 31st of this month. If you look at the St. Louis Fed, we certainly see very solid probabilities of a quarter point rate cut. We're probably not going to get that half point cut yet on the benchmark overnight lending rate. There really was a melt up. The Dow touch, I want to say 121 year high. I mean, certainly all time record weekly close in the Dow Jones Industrials, and of course, NASDAQ, S&P at records as well. What do you say, though, to folks who are convinced, you know, as long as the market's making new highs, the mutual fund money and a lot of the other pension funds and institutions will continue to pour in funds? And, you know, we've had many guests who are convinced the stock share buybacks is a huge component of this rally, and they don't see any end of that. And then we've got 18 rate cuts around the world recently from other central banks as well, which is kind of supportive liquidity. Do you think maybe we could see a gold rally, a precious metals rally, along with global equities?
Chris, I tell you, first of all, if you look back last July 31st and as we speak today, the Dow Jones Industrial Average is up less than 2%. The S&P itself is up only 2%. Gold's up almost 17%. And yet so many things, if you listen to what's said by some of the people you spoke of, or what I like to call the talking heads from the financial networks, you would have think there's been a much greater performance. Now, of course, they'll talk about just since this January, because of the mini meltdown we had in December. But given all the things you said, given the buybacks, given the dramatic interest rate cuts, given the fact that budget deficits don't even count, I mean, they actually got around to finally doing what they should have done a long time ago, and that's suspend the debt ceiling, because we've had the debt ceiling 231 times, and it's been violated. I mean, the bottom line is this. We're in whatever it is, the end stages of something that began almost 40 years ago. When I entered the business in the early 1980s, gold was predicted to go through the moon. The Business Week had run an article, a front page story, calling equities are dead. Interest rates were 18-20%, and no one thought they would ever be single digit, let alone go down to, you know, basically zero. And now, about 180 degrees or 40 years later, we're on the other spectrum. Up until recently, you found even people that used to be bullish on gold for years not even talking about it, or they ran off to pot stocks, or they ran off to, you know, cryptocurrencies or what have you, and everybody's an equity expert. And there lies a problem also, Chris. And again, I'm not a gold bug. I don't have any. I'm only interested in my own personal greedy motives. You know, people talk and realize that almost three-quarters of the licensed financial advisors now in the United States have only been licensed since the year 2000 going forward. So basically, they've been only working since the new millennium. And in that time, if you look back, and you would be shocked, even people that are involved in gold don't realize it. If you look back and you went back to January 1st, 2000, the Dow's up about 146%. The S&P is up just about 106%, and gold is up 395%. And then you can argue, okay, throw in the dividends that people would have made on the S&P and what have you, and double those returns for the Dow and the S&P, and gold still outperformed it. Yet, people talk about gold as a relic, it's a horrible investment, this, that, and the other. But meanwhile, three-quarters of the people who didn't participate in it or didn't simply see that it would outperform over the next 19 years, the very thing that everybody says is the greatest thing since, you know, bread was created, and that's, you know, the stock market. So I'm not worried about all those things that you mentioned. It is true. It's helped support it. But eventually, gravity takes hold. And the things that people have to understand, no matter how much the game has changed, and it has, it's become a high technology casino. You know, 60% of the money's in passive investments, 20% in quant. So it's not the 100% active trading we used to have, where a lot of retail participated. But eventually, stocks return to what they really are, and that's part ownership of businesses. And eventually, you can buy back all the stock you want, and so forth and so on. But if you don't start selling widgets, more widgets, if you don't start making more real profits, the value of your company is going to go down, and that's where the stock market's at now. When you compare its overall valuations, all historically, all that stuff, and you look at what's happened in the gold market, how little money has been spent for years looking for it, it's not going to turn on the dime. It's suddenly, to me, far less riskier, if you want to look at it that way, to own gold right now than it is a general equity.
Our listeners will certainly appreciate those thoughts. Okay, can we talk then about the gold to silver ratio? You know, you may have seen it recently. We touched 95, meaning that 1 ounce of gold would essentially buy about 95 silver ounces. Okay, so 1 ounce coin, gold coin, 95 silver coins. That didn't last after last week, but we're close to 90 range. Do you agree that silver represents a remarkable value, especially considering that gold to silver ratio is out of whack?
What my thought was, and what I have stated for months, and that was in the first leg, gold would lead, because it's an institutionally driven, not an industrial considered metal, why people are buying it. Once we got into the second leg that we are now, silver would start to try to catch up and sometimes lead. And that can still happen here, because now there's at least some serious interest from institutions and retail. And they tend, especially retail, to favor silver versus gold simply because people like quantity versus quality. Not to say that silver's second tier, but in a sense it is, because gold will always have be favorable. It's more of a monetary, geopolitical sort of play, than silver always gets impacted somewhat by industrial use. But needless to say, the ratio got extreme. I think it got to a 27-year difference. I think that's one of the reasons why in recent days you saw gold down but silver up, because some of that unwinding of long gold, short silver spreads were being, you know, unwound. I think they're both prepared to participate close to equal, some leading over another in this second leg up. And I just think, like I said, I think gold and silver will outperform general equities by a wide margin over the next few years. Chris, you know I'm out of the game of forecasting. I'm out of the newsletter game. I speak for myself. My business, that what's left of it in the twilight of my career, is basically planning retirement and state. So I really don't have any other incentive to, other than to speak my mind here. I know a lot of people for a lot of years have been frustrated because they don't understand. When you look at a very long picture, gold and silver continues to be one of the best places to be at. But because so many of those people tend to own mining shares, and mining shares had greatly underperformed for quite a while, and that's why there was this negative feeling about gold. And one thing I didn't point out that I think is very, very critical, in fact, it was probably in the top two reasons why I became so aggressive personally wanting to own gold, and that was we continue to see, even to this date, large purchases by central banks. Now, it's funny. The people in the financial world, what I call the don't worry, be happy crowd on Wall Street, spend 24/7 speaking about all this stuff that the central banks are doing and how bullish it is for stocks and so forth and so on. But they pay no mind to how much those central banks have been buying up gold. Now, why were they buying up gold? Well, my personal reason, particularly China and Russia's large purchases, is because they're preparing for an eventual ending of the U.S. dollar as a world reserve. In fact, a little-known news story a few months back gave me real great confidence is when Malaysia announced that it was leading an Asian group to form a new currency backed by gold where the Asian countries can trade and not use the dollar. And so I believe we're moving towards, and it still may be years away, but I think it's only going to be months or a couple of years at best, where we're going to learn that certain countries have decided to no longer use the dollar as a world reserve currency, and one of the things that will be used in that new whatever it is a gold backing. So I think that's extremely bullish, and we've seen that the charts almost go off the charts of how Russia and China has been buying. And with all that out, with no real retail interest up until most recently, the stage is set for really what I believe in a few years' time will be a challenge to new nominal all-time highs for at least gold.
That's, again, going to get a lot of people very excited on GoldSeek.com radio. Always a pleasure to speak with Peter Grandich, just a Wall Street legend, and you've got to pick up his book. We've got links to that. Can't believe he graciously gave it away. So he really does care about those of us out here who are investors and are really serious about these markets. Peter Grandich, thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Blockchain revolution is transforming the global arena, disrupting every industry in its path. GoldSeek.com is excited to introduce an off-the-chain opportunity in digital gold and silver from our friends at Atmex and Sprott.com. One Gold holds physical gold and silver metals at the Royal Canadian Mint, the first online marketplace to offer secure and convenient buying, selling, and redemption of digital precious metals. One Gold uses Vault Chain, a secure, immutable blockchain ledger developed by Tradewind Markets, the leading innovator in digital precious metals distributed ledger and blockchain technology.
vault chain. Gold and silver are 100% redeemable through One Gold for physical precious metals delivered to customers' doors in any size at competitive prices and low transaction storage costs. As a special offer and for a limited time only, One Gold is offering gold and silver at spot price with no additional premiums. OneGold.com is secure and accessible 24/7 on any device, offering convenient purchases and sales of precious metals. Easy recurring transactions make passive saving and gold dollar cost averaging as easy as a single mouse click. Vault Chain offers the best tier pricing on AppMex products, setting the industry standard as a fully backed physical asset with easy redemption in coins, rounds, or bars, offering clients peace of mind and full transparency. Don't get left behind. Remember to bookmark OneGold.com for the safest and most convenient digital precious metals today. Remember, OneGold.
GoldSeek employees may or may not own shares. Nothing contained herein should be construed as investment advice.
Shopping for fine jewelry just got easier. GoldSeek.com has identified the most successful jewelry brand to launch in recent times. Many Jewelry is rewriting the way consumers buy fine jewelry. Integrity Craftsmanship, the only company to sell 24-karat gold and platinum jewelry, avoiding confusing alloys and gems, a true precious metals investment. Many Jewelry's disruptive business model embraces Franco-American craftsmanship and direct-to-consumer economics, rapidly disrupting the $20 billion monopoly, just like Amazon and Uber. The sky is the limit with $1 billion of jewelry purchases daily for loved ones and those special occasions. Many Jewelry is an innovator positioned to capture market share, with annual sales growth in the industry topping $30 billion by 2021. Many Jewelry coined the term investment jewelry, pricing by the gram, transparently disclosing its profit margins, a truer investment in pure gold or platinum. Similar to real estate, even artwork, Many Jewelry has a weighted value easily calculated, ensuring value wealth as a long-term investment. With sales in 60 countries around the globe, 20,000 orders already, don't miss out on the explosive growth potential. Many Jewelry trades under the symbols MENE on the Toronto Exchange, and in the US, MENEF. Remember to sign up to Many's Shareholder Club to receive shareholder news, updates, and special discount codes for jewelry purchases. Remember, Many Jewelry.
GoldSeek employees may or may not own shares. Nothing contained herein should be construed as investment advice.